Hello and welcome to part 4 of the series on how to create the web WhatsApp UI with React.js. In this part, we are going to create the contact list we see on the left side right here. So, we are going to create that in the purple section you see right here. We're going to first open up our source, checkbox.tsx, and right here, we want to create a couple of contacts. So, we are going to do this by adding data to our project. So ideally, you want to use an API and you want to fetch the contacts from that API. But right now, we are going to use a local JSON file. So in our source folder, we're going to create a new folder named data. And inside of the data folder, we are going to create a contacts.json folder or file actually. And right here, we want to create a list. And in this list, we have objects. And each object will have a profile image, which will be the path to the profile image. In this case, it will be this image, the default image. So we say assets images frontend coding.png. Then we will have a name. So right here we say name. The name will be, for example, let's say Alex. And then we will have a description. So we say description, or actually I think it is called status in WhatsApp. We say status, and for the status we say, hey there, I am using WhatsApp. Hey there, I am using WhatsApp, like so. So now we have one user, but we actually want to create a lot. So I'll be back in a second. So I have added more contacts, and right now we should have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 contacts. So now that we have our contacts, we want to actually use them. So inside of here, we have our list, and we actually want to render a list of contacts. So in here we have a div, another div, and each div will be a contact. This will be contact 1, right here we have contact 2, and if we save this up, we see that our contacts are appearing. But instead of rendering them like so, we actually want to map our contact array, which we have right here. So we say import contacts from, let's see, dot slash data, contacts.json, like so. Now we can say right here that we want to say contacts.map. Now we loop through every contact, and then we want to return a new div element with, for example, the name of the contact. So we say c.name, like so, and if we save this up, we'll see that we have all our contacts appearing right here. So we now have the base foundation for rendering contacts. What we want to do right now, we actually want to create a component for them. So in our components folder, we're going to create a new folder named contact. And in this contact folder, we're going to write a contact.tsx file and a contact.css file. So right here, we are going to just write the default function. And we are going to import the CSS. Like so. And then what we want to do is, instead of rendering the contacts right here, we want to render the contacts right here. So instead of returning this div, we want to return a contact, and we are going to import it from our component. So we say import contact from .contact/contact. So, and we are actually going to move this to up here, like so. And then, as we will see, we will return a contact. So we should see this appearing for something like 8 or 9 times. So as you can see, we now have all our contacts, but the names are gone. And that is because we cannot display the contact name right here. So in order to display the contact name right here, we need to be able to pass in the contact to our component. So right here, we want to create an interface props. And right here, we expect a contact, which will be of type contact. But as you can see, we don't have a contact type. It's right now, it's just of type object. So we actually want to create a type for it. And we're going to create a new folder in our source folder, named models. And here we're going to create a contact.tsx. And this contact.tsx is going to be export interface contact. And right here, we write the attributes that the contact has. So we have a profile image, which is of type string. Then we have a name and a status, which are also both type string, like so. And now we save this contact model. And right here, we can say that it is of type contact. So we first import the contact model, import contact from models, contact, like so. And as you can see, names are clashing. They are trying to be the most important name, but they are the same name, so that's not happening. So we can actually rename this import. We can do that by adding curly brackets and saying contact as contact model. And maybe we don't even need to add those curly brackets. No, we do need to add it. So now we have saved this as this. So we can use just the contact model as a class right here. So now the contact is of contact model type. And we want to be able to pass in those props right here. So we say contact, which is of type props. And now the contact component expects a contact to be passed in. So right here, we see that we get an error. And the error is property contact is missing in type, but required in type props. So right here, it expects us to type in the contact. And for the contact, we want to pass in C, because C is the contact that we are currently handling. So if we save this up, we'll see that it's still rendering contact. And now in our contact.tsx, we can change this hard-coded text with the name. We say contact.name. And if we save this up, we'll see that we get all the names of our contact. So what we did right now is actually just the same as we did right here with rendering the div. But right now we have a separate component, which organizes the code a lot better. And now that we have this down, we actually want to create the contact. So for the contact, we have a profile image, a name, and a status. And we are actually going to use grid. So right here, we have one, two rows. First row is for the image and the name. And the second row is for the image and the description. So we're going to give this a class name of contact, like so. And in our contact.css, we're going to write that contact display grid. We want to say grid template areas. We have profile picture. Let's call this just picture. And we have the name. And then we have the picture and the description. Or well, actually the status. Like so. So right now, we click on a contact. We should see the grid appearing. Yes. So now that we have our grid, we actually want to create the elements. So right here, instead of rendering the name, we want to render an image. We want to render span, and we want to render another span. So this image will be the profile picture. This span will be the name. And this span will be the status. So, and for the profile picture, we actually already can import the picture. So we say source equals curly brackets, and then we can type in a variable, and the variable will be contact.profileImage. So right now, this is just referring to our local image, which is this one. But what you want to do in your own project, or when you create a project which communicates with an API, you want to replace this with something like HTTP colon slash slash www your server dot com slash API slash user slash media, and then for example some arbitrary string dot png. So this should be the URL for your profile picture. So We are not going to use that right now, we are just going to use the local image. So if we save this up, we see our image appearing, and we also see that it's way too big. So let's first start with assigning each element to the correct grid template area. So right here, I'm going to close this and this. We can specify that we want to target the profile picture. I want to say grid area is picture. And we're going to do the same for the name and the status. Right here, we're going to target the name and the status. This will have a grid area of name and this one of status, like so. And if we save this up, we will see nothing changing yet. But as you can see, the grid area is being applied and the grid is still here. So what we want to do now is we actually want to fill in a name. So we can say contact.name, like so. And then right here we can say contact.status. And if we save this up, we see that they are actually already in the correct position. So the name is on the top section and the status on the bottom section. So first things first, we want to limit the size of the contact to something like the size of the details right here. So if we open up our chat box, we have the details right here somewhere. Yeah, and let's see, the details are the first row, so that should be 90 pixels. So let's make the contact also 90 pixels. In our contact.css, we have the contact, and right here let's give it a height 90 pixels. As you can see, everything has shrunk, but because the image is still too big, our contact is a little bit overflowing. So to fix this, we can just say for our picture to be of width 48 pixels and height 48 pixels, like so. And right now our picture is a lot smaller. We actually wanted to make it a little bit bigger, I think. Let's go with 64. And we want to make it round. We want to give it a border radius, 50%, like so. Next, we want to, move everything a little bit from the left. So we want to give each contact a padding left 20 pixels, like so. And then we want to give them a little bit of padding from the top. So, and from the bottom as well, actually. So we're going to say padding. We're actually going to write this above here. Padding 0 pixels, and then padding 5, 10 pixels, and then 0 pixels, like so. So now they also have a little bit of padding on the top and the bottom. And what we want to do then is we actually want to remove the background color because it is not purple, or it shouldn't be purple. Right here we remove this. We actually want to grab the correct background color. It's just white. So we're going to say background color white, like so. And now we have this. And what we want to do right then is we want to add a border on the bottom of every contact. And what I'm noticing right here is that the border bottom is not on the image, but it is on the text right here. So let's do this by adding a border bottom on the status in our contact.css. A border bottom of 1 pixel solid black. And as you can see, now they have a border bottom, but everything is actually being pushed to the right, it looks like. So that's actually not what we want. We want our text to be aligned on the left side. So to fix this, we actually need to specify the size of the columns. So the first column should be something like 64 pixels, since that's the size of the profile picture. And second column should fill in the rest. So right here, we can say grid template columns, 64 pixels and auto. And if we save this up, we see that the text is now next to the image actually. So to give it some spacing, we are actually going to increase this to 96 pixels, like so. And maybe decrease it to 80 pixels. So next up, we actually want to make the border a different color. I think we should make it the same color as the search bar border. So in the chatbox.css, we should have the border of the search bar. Let's see right here. Let's just take this one and put it right here. Like so, yeah. So if we save this up, we see a nice little border. We want to make the name a little bit bigger. So for the grid area name, we're going to say font size of 1 rem, 1.5 rem, and that might be a little bit too big, 1.4, 3, yeah, 1.3, or well, maybe 1.2 rem looks fine, like so. So now we have the name, and then we want to make the description or the status a little bit grayish. So right here we have the status. I want to say color. We want to actually put it underneath here. Color of RGB. And then we want to give it a color of something like 100. Something like this. So I think this looks good. So next up, we actually want to decrease the size of the profile picture, I think. So right here, let's go with 56 pixels. Like so. And what we want to do then is we actually want to make separate div for this. So right now we have the border bottom on the status, but it is actually nicer to have the border bottom on the section right here, since this is one section. We are going to create a div around this, and let's call this div details or contact details. So as you can see right now, they have a green background color because the chatbox also has a div named details. So let's say to the chatbox, hey, you can only spell the details that are a direct child of you by saying this. As you can see, they are no longer green. And then we actually want to give the details the correct position in the grid. So right now we specify the grid template area with name and a status. But those are actually in the details. Let's just give this name of details. So, and then inside of our details, we want to display it as a flex element, like so. Then we want to say that we want to give it a flex direction of column, so. And then what we can do is we can say to our details, hey, give the margin or the border bottom not to the status, but to the details, so. And I think it already looks a lot better. But one thing I'm noticing is that they are really spaced out far from each other. So let's decrease the height, 80 pixels, and maybe even to 70. Yeah. So now that everything is a little bit more spaced to each other, we actually do want to increase the space between the status and the border bottom. So now we can really easily do that by adding some margin or padding bottom to the details. Right here we say padding bottom of 5 pixels, maybe even 15. And as you can see, the status bar or the border bottom is now moving lower. So to finish it off, let's give the contact list a border top of a dark color. As we can see right here, it also has a border top. Let's make the list scrollable, because as you can see right now, it is flowing out of the chat box. So to make it scrollable, that's really easy. You can apply that to the chatbox right here. We apply it to the list element right here. And we want to say overflow y scroll, like so. But right now we can scroll through the contacts. And we want to add the border top to the contacts. Or we could add a border bottom to the search bar. I think that's what we're going to do. We're going to add a border bottom to the search bar. So right here, a border bottom, like so. 1 pixel solid black. Let's see, now I have a nice little border, and we actually want to make it different color. I think the same color as we did with the icons. Let's go with hashtag 7, yes. And now we want to change the color of the border. I think we want to use the same color as we do for the icon right here. So in the chat box, we are going to the search section. And then we have the search label SVG. Want to take this color, put it right here, save it up. Let's just make it a little bit lighter, like so. And if we save this up and refresh the page, we'll see that we now have a nice border between the contacts and between the search section. As you can see, the border is staying in place and we can nicely scroll through all the contacts. So one last thing before we finish this episode is we don't want to add a border button to the last element. So we can really easily fix this by applying some CSS. We are going to open up our chatbox.css, and inside of here we have our list. We then want to target that list, and we want to target the last contact inside of that list. So if we look in the vector, you see that we have chatbox, list, and inside this list we have contacts. We want to target the last contact. We say content last of type. And then let's say, for example, background color purple. Let's see how this works. The last contact has a purple background color. What we actually want to do is we want to change the border. So we go into the details. So here we say dot details. Now the details are purple. And then we want to remove the padding bottom and the border bottom. We just copy over this. Give this a padding bottom of 0 pixels and a border of none, like so. And we do want to have a curly bracket right here. If we save this up, we see that we still have a purple color. So if we refresh the page, the purple color is gone. We don't have a border bottom anymore, and the element is just displaying nicely. So with this, I want to end this episode right here. I want to thank you for watching. I hope you could follow along. Leave a like, comment down below, subscribe, and I'll see you in the next episode. Bye!